Alright YouTube, in this video what we are going to see is how to create a mega menu. What do I mean by mega menu? As you can see on the screen, when I hover on the product, you will see the mega menu with the help of a little CSS animation, but purely CSS. We are not going to touch JavaScript here, we are just going to see how does it works in CSS. And as I should mention, this is responsive as well. If you want the source code, you'll get the source code in the description. Now let me show you how does it look in responsive. The same way, not an issue. Now let me show you how the HTML works. First of all, I want to remove all the CSS and show you from scratch. Basically, we have a container which is called a navbar, which holds the anchor tag 1, anchor tag 2, and after the anchor tag 2, we have a product tab. This product is surrounded with the help of div, and this div has an anchor tag at first, but after the anchor tag it has a drop down content. Whatever you see below on the red color, it is on the class drop down content. And then we are going to have inside the drop down content, we are going to have inside the drop down content we are going to have some rows with columns. As you can see, we have one row. We have to find where is the row, and the row is over here, and inside the row we have some set of column. The first column which has the image of the Bruce Lee, and later all the columns we have some set of links, and this is just a temporary link. I just added the product 1, and so we don't have to worry about much. Now this is what it looks like without CSS. Now I'm going to apply CSS for the class. I just wanted you to go through what are the classes and what are the div I have applied. If you want, you can pause the video and resume it. Don't worry, you'll get the source code. Now let me quickly jump into the CSS. I'm going to choose the container, and this container is going to have background as black, and the width is going to be of course 100% to cover the full screen. And then we are going to have overflow hidden. I'll show you why I added overflow header at the end of the video. You don't have to worry much about it. And inside the navbar we have some anchor tag, and these anchor tag would be having let me remove the image, it is spoiling our view. I just made space so that I can get a broken image by myself. Fine. Now I'm going to have the color white, and followed by I need to have a padding for it, and I have to remove the underline for the anchor tag with the help of text decoration none, which will remove the anchor tag. And then I need padding of 14 pixel top and bottom, 14 pixel left and right. Now, and that seems appropriate. Now I want all the anchor tag to float left to the container, and now that's great, we got it. And then I'm going to do what? I'm going to align all the h3. We have a h3, and this h3 to have a class which will have a color of let the same color be white for h3 as well. And now it is pretty clear. Now I'm going to, for the drop down class which surrounds your drop down link, and this should also be float left. And once this is done, before that I would like you to give the navbar a height which would be approximately 60 pixel or 50 pixel. And yes, it worked absolutely fine. Let me give the body a color so that we can see the color of the anchor tag. The color of the body would be #EDEBEE, which is a gray color, and I want to remove all the default added margin and padding. Yes, we got it. And now I want the drop down to have position relative, because Let the color of the anchor tag be yellow for just a moment so that you can clearly see whatever anchor tag, where and where our anchor tag looks like. And that seems appropriate. We have to remove the overflow to see our anchor tags. And yes. And now the very next thing is I want to display the drop down content right below our drop down div. So for that I would be adding position absolute, and then I would be adding left of 0 pixel. Now you got it right, and don't worry about it. The very next thing what we are going to do is we are going to give the drop down content the width of 100%. To showcase your skills, you just have to have a background color of red. And once this is done, you are required to get into the class column and then give the width. Since we have 4 columns, we will distribute by 100% width all the columns, so it would be 25% width for 4 columns to make it 100. And now as we have added position left, I would request you to add position top as well. From the height of the navbar is 50, so I'll give 60 pixel from top 50, which will not get any gap. And after that I want to make the drop down content full width. With the help of, we just have to remove our position relative, because that is what making the that's what made the problem for us. Now after that we have specified the column width as 25%, we would be adding the image inside the column would have a height and width img. The height would be 250 pixel, the same the width would be 250 pixel. If you want you can increase it, we have to increase it. And now I have to give the column of height, let's say 300 pixel. And after that I want the column to float left one after the other. And yes, once it is done, I want the anchor tag inside the column class should also get the float, or it should not get the float display block. If it doesn't work, we have to try something else. Float none. As well as display block. And yes, we got it. Let the image have padding of 20 pixel on all that sides, all its size. Then in order to remove these things, you have to add, before everything you have to make the star. That means for every classes we use or every tag inside the style sheet I use, I need to have box sizing border box. And yes, we got it. If you think that 10% is too or 20% is too much, you can reduce it by 10%, and that seems appropriate. If you want the anchor tag to be in the center, you can also have text align :center, and so the anchor tag, so the heading tag as well. H3 is our heading tag, so text align center, which will align our heading and the related anchor tag. Now if you want, you can also, let me reduce it by 290. And that's okay. Now I want the hover effect. So for that, you have to choose every anchor tag. Let's choose Z. If I hover on anchor tag, I want the background color to change to black. This should be on a very slow. For that transition, I'll show you without transition first. It is changing to black, but it is too quick. I won't want it to be too quick. In order to slow down the process, you would be adding transition 1s, 1 second, and fine, that works absolutely great. And then it's time for our drop down content to get the attribute display none. And if I hover on the drop down div, I want the drop down content to show up. This is the trick to show. If I hover on the container, I want the child to show up. Display block. And yes, you got it. The same way. Sorry. Add the translate. Transform. Translate from y-axis. Let it be -600 pixel. Let it go to the top. And when I hover, I want it to be to get the translate of 0. So it is too quick. In order to slow down, you would be adding transition. Transition 1 second, that will come from the top. The scope of this video is done. Thank you so much for listening. Get the source code in the description, and this would be responsive as well. Fine.